I'm going to show you a few games now that we play in class. Two of the games deal with the dictionary. One of them we have not played yet. But the first one is called the Megan game or the dictionary game. Every team is on the scoreboard and the points are empty at the start. Now let's say group one was going to start. I would read a definition or even give them a definition of a word and then they're going to try and guess what it is. So I said something to the effect of, this is something that you might say to a child who has done well. Something you might say to a child who has done well. A word that you might use to describe what they've done. Group number one. And so what they do is they have this word, and group one's going to discuss as a group. And they say, well, it's 5 letters long, something you would say. And if they get it right on the first guess, they get 1 point for the word. Then if the letters go across, there's more points available, every letter and the word. So here we go. What do you guys think? Someone's done something, they've done it really well. You might use this word to describe that. 5 letters. What do you think, group one? Going once, going twice. Okay, now, group number two. Now it gets a little easier because they've got the clue of the first letter. It's like an on-the-board crossword puzzle game where there's the spaces, now they've got one letter clue.
Great.
It would be great. So they get 1 point for the letter, 1 point the word, and group two would have 2 points, and then we fill it in, and I have all the kids write that in. And then we also take time to discuss what's unique about that word, with some way, on a way to remember how to spell that, a way to remember it. And you can use this with different things you talked about during the day, or just come up with random words. Another dictionary game that we have not played yet is Dictionary Race. I've got tons of dictionaries in the back room. What we do in this one is I just say a word, and the class tries to be the first one to find it. So they'll go through that. So if I said disappointment, they go this way and that way and this way and this way. And they go bingo! And everyone stops at bingo. And if a person from that group has found that word first, that group gets a point. Because the dictionary is organized alphabetically. We have not played that yet, but it's kind of fun. It's kind of a speed game. You can press the red button now. Thanks. So in the Megan game, you just go around and around and around with these words. It keeps going. You can play up to 10. You can play up to 20. It's a great game. It's kind of an on-whiteboard spelling game. Now the next one we play is Brain Quest. We like this one too. Let's say group number one was going to start the game. I've got questions here in this deck. They're paperclip to the next question that we've been on. And I might ask something like this. What mammal can fly? That's the first question on this card. I ask it to group two. Group two gets the first, it's a scoreboard just like this again. Group two gets the first chance to do it. What mammal can fly, group two? So they say bat, they get the point for that question. Now let's say we're playing and they didn't get it right, group three would get a chance to steal. So it would go to group three, they could steal it, and then they would get another question. We're in the Megan game keeps going around the room. In this game, if three steals group two's question, they would get another one. So let's say group two got it wrong, and group three said bat, they would also get the next question, which would be their question. So I might say to group three, what letter begins the word knowledge? So they say K, that's correct, and then they get another point. And this deck is full of teachable moments. You can go through any question. Sometimes the questions are so hard, it makes it all the way around the room. The question's been passed, and then it's a push, and the group gets another question again. But we teach from these questions too. Like, who remembers, just an example, who remembers the three states of matter? Yes?
Solid, ice, water, and liquid, and gas.
Yes, there it is. So we learn that by playing Brain Quest. It's quite the game. You can hit the button again, Asha. This is a great math warm-up game. If you come in from recess and show and tell is done, these are all math Brain Quest questions. This kind of gets the same way they play the same game, but let's say it's group four's turn. They're going to go first, and I would ask them, how many numbers are there from 1 to 100? Group number four, how many numbers are there from 1 to 100?
99.
It's a good guess. Group number five gets this chance to steal. So four wins, five's gonna try and steal that. How many numbers are from 1 to 100? Okay, and group five misses, that's okay. Group six gets a chance to steal, but still, we're gonna go back to five for the next question.
100.
It's 100, it's 100. So six would get that point, and now it would be five's turn. Now another thing, there's all kinds of lessons with Brain Quest 2 about being a good teammate. Make sure you discuss with your group before you blurt something out, because it's easy for the group to go, what were you doing? I mean, we didn't even have a chance to say that. You want to learn how to work within a group, so there's all kinds of lessons going on. So we got math Brain Quest, and then we got the general Brain Quest. Who cares about Nasha? About the Megan game, that's the dictionary kind of crossword puzzle. We talked about Brain Quest in general. We talked about Brain Quest math. Now here's a class favorite. They'd play this all day if you let them. I mean, if you said, well, I don't know what to do next, just pull out these cards. What we do is every group, we have a runner, one position from the group comes up, they get five cards. And then I'm actually the one that calls out the green card to match. So just for example, let's say my group number one's cards are Ice Skating, Dirty Socks, Big Bird, Bert and Ernie, and Jail. And then I'm gonna, all groups have five cards, I pull out Useful. They're gonna find the most, they're gonna talk together as a group, find the word, the card that they have that goes best with Useful, and they're gonna come up and put it in this box. I'll put six more red cards, one for each group, sitting out here on the table. They bring it up, they grab a new card, and then I'll look at all the cards and review, and I'll pick the one that goes best, and they would get the point on the scoreboard. So that's another one, and the kids just, they'll tell you how to play it. They love, love, love this game. And it's good for reading. It's talking adjectives and nouns and all kinds of good things. What did you guys choose? Jail. Well, this wasn't a roundabout way. Yes, it is. Very useful. Thanks. So that's apples to apples. You can press the button. Another game you can play, and this is more to the kids, they know how to play it, is a number topping. What they're going to do is they're going to take out all the numbers that are above 10. So they narrow it down, because there's 18s in here, but anything that's 10 or under, they're going to take those cards and they're going to divvy them out, and then they lay down two cards. It's just adding those two cards together. So I lay down a 6 and an 8, and let's say the person I'm playing lays down an 8 and a 2. Well, what's 8 plus 2? What does the other person have? 10. And I got 6, I have 8, 6 and 8, what do I have? 14. Who gets those four cards? I do, because my total is greater. Now, if you want to challenge yourself, you can go to three cards. And you'll lay out three cards and add them, or you can multiply them with your grid and your math journal, you know, the multiplication grid. So there's a lot of different options with addition topping. So you can stop that. Thanks. The last game is called Money Roll, and this one, I gotta warn the sub, is a little bit more messy. Because what we do is we each get a sheet of paper on our desk, a big sheet like this. There's a sheet for the front two people and a sheet for the back three. And I come over and I actually take a whole handful of change and put it right on their game board. I just kind of put it out there. So everybody gets a handful of change. Then what the kids are going to do is they're going to roll their die and they're going to collect that much money for every roll. So Izzy would roll. Izzy rolls the die. She rolls a 6, so she's going to pull 6 cents onto her desk. She gets 6 cents. Did you get your 6? So she's going to grab 6 cents. She grabbed a nickel and a penny. And that's right, she wants to make it as few coins as possible. So she's going to go a nickel and a penny, and then Catherine would roll. Catherine's going to roll, and she's going to roll a 3. So she'd grab 3 pennies. And then it's going to be Izzy's turn, and she's going to roll and add to her 6 cents. So now Izzy's going to roll. She rolls another 6. So she's going to grab 6 cents. And in this case, what she's doing is she grabbed a nickel and a penny again, but then she grabbed the two nickels and traded that in for a dime. So right now she has a dime and two pennies because she wants the least amount of coins. Now this one's a little messier because now I gotta go to each group and drop a handful of change on every one of these mats as we go around the room. The people in the back seats, you're gonna play 3 across. You each take a turn going 3 across. Everybody would. This one gets a little louder, but it is a great game for combining numbers that deal with money. So the money roll is another good game for a warm-up. Give me the button. Thanks. So, in the end, there's a bunch of games that we have enjoyed playing so far as a class, and one we haven't yet, the dictionary game. But the Megan game is that on-board kind of crossword puzzle. Brain Quest is just playing right out of the deck, asking questions, kind of like a Trivial Pursuit, but many, many teachable moments. Brain Quest Math is math questions, or the deck that's really focused on math questions. Apples to Apples, the kids will play it all day long. It really is fun. It's a great word game. Number Top, it is more with the kids. These first games are going to be led by you, the teacher. These last two games are games that the kids can actually, you'll pass out the stuff for them to play, and then the kids will play the games. That's really more up to them. So there's a good variety of games here for warm-ups and in between time, but like I said, the dictionary game, the Megan game, Brain Quest, Apples to Apples, Number Top, and Money, all good games. Oh, and we do play for a trophy. It's kind of a piece of garbage taped together thing. We call it the chalice, so the team that wins that. And we always remind each other, it's just a game. And we're learning lessons of working with a group, not blurting out, making sure we're checking with our group. And this group is in particularly great at complimenting one another when they do win. If another team wins, they don't hold it against them. They're like, wow, good for you. You did a real nice job with that. And I think this class is a great, great, it's a unique feature of this group of children, and they do a really, really nice job with it. So that's it for now, but thanks for watching.